We're all very close,
yeah,
aren't we?
Yeah.
Nana comes around every day to
I do.
See us.
I do. As old as you get, I'm always there for you. Yeah. Ella, how can I describe you? Well, you're a lovely little girl. You are. I'm very proud of you, what you've achieved.
Thank you.
And the mum, my daughter, she's just working all the time, aren't you?
You're a hard worker.
But I'm always there for them.
And
always.
Nana, you're very generous.
I worry about you like I don't know.
You worry about everybody and don't
I do
think
worry about
yourself.
Everybody. I've always done what I'm doing now, haven't I? Because you've worked.
Run round after us.
Yeah. It's two kids, yeah.
No, I moved in the flat and I got Meals on Wheels.
Yeah. She did when she left home. Used to deliver Meals on Wheels and a bag of shopping. I have found my friend on you and I go out with you wherever you go.
I know you do.
See, I like to know what you're doing as well, don't I?
Yeah.
She does it, you don't mind, dear Elle, because I'm not going to phone you or anything. It's just nice to know where you are, that's all. Or if you're somewhere and I'll say, why didn't she tell me she was going there?
That's all we get.
Why do I not know?
So what, you wouldn't be mad if I was tracking you saying...
No.
No, she'd love it.
Oh, I'd love it. Yeah.
She'd feel wanted.
You can come out with me then, can't you? Yeah. Because you are growing up and your mum keeps telling me you're growing up and you don't need me like you did. It's just my way of keeping you here inside.
Yeah.
That's all it is. I'm not being nosy when I say what you're doing at weekend, Ella.
Well, I don't care if you're tracking me.
No, and that's good. Some people wouldn't
feel left out.
Oh, I'm not being tracked. We tried to add you in and you left.
Yeah. Well, you don't really need support, do
not
you?
At the moment, but hopefully,
in the future,
when I need
you
it,
will.
I hope it'll be there.
And we will be there.
Yeah.
She'll be very good.
You've been supportive. You would be supportive.
I am supportive.
And you have been supportive. When he had my cancer, you was a bit young, that you were supportive then, and I'd had COVID, and you helped me through that, didn't you?
I got you shopping.
Oh dear, that was a time, wasn't it?
Yeah,
do you remember?
It was. You were really ill.
Oh God, yeah. So yeah, and I know she'd be there.
And all and all we hear about you is that you're old and don't put me in a home. So we've had that conversation.
Would you
we're
never
not
go
allowed.
In a home? Never going home.
I can't say that, but to be honest, I felt old from getting
God,
my 60th birthday.
About 40,
but
you were
talk,
old.
No, you don't talk to me about it.
You've
I keep bringing it up.
You've been saying that you're dying for since I've been born.
No, I'm just getting things ready.
You've like, not got long now.
No, wait, this will see
no,
me
I'll
out.
Say you'll miss me if I've gone.
You'll be like, this is my last holiday now. No. Before I'm off.
Yeah, this is my last car. This will see me through now.
You don't want to listen to me. That's the problem. How old is when your wrinkles come? Your eyes are not as sparkly as they used to be. Your grey hair comes. The first thing that you'll notice when you're older is the stairs. That's the first thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like granddad, I can run up them. At the moment, you never want to discuss that part because you think it won't come. I was the same when I was younger with my mum. You think your mum's always going to be there, but you know. You don't want to see it. You don't want to look that far ahead.
Because she lives for the day.
Age and grace is looking after yourself, basically. Keeping active, doing exercise what you can, or what you enjoy and everything, and just
looking
out,
after yourself.
Going out.
Living life.
If you can, yeah. So if I was on my own, I don't know what I'd do. I think I'd move in with your mum. I've done all my will, power of attorney, and so all that's done. Don't put me in a home.
I won't.
Yeah, that's something that's happening today, isn't it? Everybody's getting themselves ready, paying for it, so you don't have any problems when I'm gone.
I've even thought about
I have told you what I want.
I like to be organised and I don't want you to worry about anything when I die.
Is it expensive?
It's not cheap.
Oh God.
But it's worth just having a plan in place, isn't it? Probably easier just to sort a funeral.
You have to involve people in the caring, whereas at the funeral
you can do it yourself, can't you?
And you don't want to burden other people no. with the care.
I think if you lived on your own and you've not got no family coming in, then the alarm is the best fit, is the best thing. Other than that, if you've got nobody coming in, you're going to be on the floor for a long time.
It's more peace of mind, isn't it?
Yeah.
Security.
I think I can talk about care because of the way we've grown up with each other.
We
see each other every day.
Talk about
I talk about anything. Yeah, I do. I know she'll do her best for me. So I know she'll. And if she can't cope, I don't expect her to do. You know, what will be, and.